Well, it's Monday morning, here we are back at the pack, and I'm back in the snag swim again. The wind, as you can see, is coming in very nicely. The spot seems to be clean. I've been keeping a little bit of bait going in, not a lot, just a trickle. And fish have been coming in and clearing it up. Hopefully they were carp and not tenchel bream. So yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit here, I think, for most of the day. And the reason for that is that we have three other anglers on today. We have one over in the top bay, one in Fields Mate, and one in the Fields. He's the first angler to fish the Fields for probably a month or so. So what I was actually going to do is I was going to go over there and bait up. But obviously can't do that if there's other anglers around. It wouldn't really be fair on them. So I'm going to wait until they go later on today. And then I'm going to go over to the shallows and fish it and bait up when I leave.
Because we must get that swim going. Martin's been down at the weekend and he's been putting some bait in for me as well. Not a lot, just a bit here and there. He's got one of his swims prepared and ready. In fact, he even went for a swim at the weekend. We're being quite busy little bees at the moment on the pack here. I think this spot is actually fished out, but having said that, you know, there's still some carp to be caught from here. Although it could be hard going, we'll have to see. I'm going to keep my eye on the spot by going up the tree. Kettle's on, and it's just boiling, so time for breakfast. Well, the wind certainly got up nicely. I have to say I love it when it's like this. It's really blowing in here, quite gusty. The water is very, very clear. Now it seems, or it appears to me anyway, to be a lot clearer than it was a week or two ago. So there you go. I don't know what it's like down in Lenny's Bay or the Top Bay. I'll have a look later. The conditions do look good, and I do feel that one or two fish will pass through this spot. I've only lightly baited it, and of course I've got the three bags out
in the usual spots.
And what I would really like to catch today, well, 30 pound common would be nice. There's a couple of them in here. Well, we'll see.
I don't know how I manage it actually, but every Monday it's like a fresh adventure. My enthusiasm throughout the entire year has only really dipped the once. That was earlier on in the year when I was doing a heck of a lot of fishing. Sometimes too much of a good thing, you know, can be bad for you. I've no plans on coming fishing tomorrow because I have to do a lot of work, but I'm going to bait up tonight quite heavily in the hope that that will sustain the spots until I get back on Tuesday.
Martin, of course, will be down. And I think this week
we're entertaining a guest on this water this week. One of Martin's relatives.
An old carp angler like myself who's been around, hasn't been fishing for a while, and fancy getting the Cardinal 55s out again and the old monkey climbers. So that should be interesting. It'd be like stepping back into the past walking into this guy's swim, I think. Looking forward to it, great deal. Well, it's about 11:30 and the sun is just about to swing round to the right here, and when it does, that spot will shine up a lot more, and that's the kind of time, coincidentally, that the carp have been arriving in this swim in the last couple of weeks. Although the last session I did in here, I only spotted one carp come anywhere near the area, and it soon vacated. It was one of the fish I was after as well. It was one of the larger commons. So, yeah. But we're going to try and get other areas going, not just rely on this spot. However, it's Monday. It's the start of the week. I've got the rest of the week to get into the groove. Comes the sunshine. Well, it's about 12:30, and this is around the time, of course, that the carp tend to show themselves on this side of the lake and in this corner. Obviously, the swim's a little bit blown, and I think they might be avoiding it. However, having said that, the last time I caught a fish in this swim was last Wednesday, so that's a fair few days ago, and so the swim has been rested for a good 4 or 5 days. It's had bait going into it, so I'm hoping that the fish are going to show themselves in here. We'll have to see. I haven't actually seen a fish on the spot yet, but however, I've only been up the tree 3 or 4 times, and that's no indication that the fish hasn't been there, because of course they can appear from nowhere and disappear just as quickly. Well, I'm pretty sure I've just had a pickup, a left-hand rod, a couple of bleeps. I quickly got up the tree and had a look, couldn't see a fish in the swim, but the left-hand rod is right on the edge of the spot. It's actually probably nearer the chod than anything else, so yeah, I'm hoping it's not a jolly green giant, of course, because yeah, when they're in the swim, it usually means that the carp are not. But yeah, that's a good sign. I'm pleased about that. That's the first bleep I've had all day, and it definitely was a fish, because the wind's been hammering in here all day and it hasn't gone bleep. So yeah, so I'm gonna keep nipping up the tree and keep my eyes peeled, as they say. With any luck, there might be a carp mooching around. I might pick it up, because there's not a lot of bait out there. There's only a little bit. Certainly any respectable size carp clear it up in minutes. Yeah. Left hand rod. That's the one. Well, it's very quiet here. I haven't seen a single fish moving into this area at all, which is a shame, because I really would like to catch one, of course. The wind has been banging in beautifully all day, but that's really not made any difference. But I really do want to fish this swim out. I want to stay here and make sure for myself that there's nothing coming in here anymore. And then I'll be quite happy to move on, as it were.